Hi, this is Sally Morgan, physical therapist, craniosacral therapist, and Tellington Tea Touch practitioner for animals and people. Oh, now I can see you guys. And this is Tristan, he's a corgi, and we're here for an episode of Conversations with a Corgi. And boy, sadly, in the last 2 weeks, I've come across two dogs that I know that have been diagnosed with cancer. And it always reminds me of my sister's wonderful Cabochon, Myra, who was doing great and thriving and then had lymphoma, I believe. And my sister did something that more and more dog people are doing, and I think it's brilliant, which is to make a bucket list for their dog with whatever time they have left. And so they try to write down the things that the dog has always loved to do, certain walks, certain friends to play with, things they like to eat, and then check those things off with the dog. And spend time doing what your dog loves. And I think that is such a good thing to do. And it's so therapeutic for you too, because those memories that you're gonna have as you work through your dog's bucket list are gonna sustain you. And now it's so easy to take lots of pictures while that's happening. And what I encourage you to do is not wait till your dog is 19 years old or really sick. Do that dog's bucket list now. Like, do it this year, do it in the next 6 months. And not because he's gonna die, but because you wanna spend time with him and love what he loves. So take him for that puppuccino, take him to the beach, take him to visit his friends, do a walk where he can smell the whole way, even if you only go 10 feet. Have his friends over, run around the backyard, have a dog birthday party, which my dog Comet loved right before he passed over. And really just try to think of the things your dog really likes to do and do them with him. And sometimes it's hard for people to come up with these things, but I suggest making a number, 25, 10, 50, if you're really ambitious, and just start doing those fun things with your dog that would be his bucket list. You know, my sister did things like taking her dog for a bike ride around the local town, taking her over to this park that was near them, and just letting her run around and lay in the sun for as long as she wanted, a couple of hours, and taking her for rides in the convertible with the top down. You know, dogs love that wind in their face sometimes, and Myra certainly was no exception. She made her special food, lots of snuggle time in the evening. Sometimes we think our bucket lists are things like, you know, going to some big festival or some foreign place, but for your dog's bucket list, it might be sleeping in the bed with you or snuggling on the sofa. Or one thing Tristan would put on his list is playing throw the squeaky for as long as he wants, right? Because mommy's arm always gets tired before you do. And he has done such a good job of trying to make it so easy for me to play squeakies with him. I mean, I literally can sit on the sofa and toss the toy over the other sofa, and he runs around and gets it and comes back. And he really likes the tug of war that he creates to get the toy from him, which is the part of it I don't like, and it's his favorite part. If we could just tug a little less, we could throw squeakies a lot more. So it could be something simple like that that your dog loves. And certainly walking with your dog, as much as we love it, they love it too. And look at doing things that they like to do on their walks, walking with their friend or smelling everything. Dogs love smells. Now, we've had some coyotes around here, and when I took Tristan on his walk yesterday, they must have trotted near the road in this one section where we were by some people's lawns. And one of the lawns is chem lawn, so we couldn't go quite up on that. But when we got a little further down the road, oh my God, I mean, I waited 15 minutes and he's smelling like a 6 foot line that he thought was delicious. And I was really impatient because I was exhausted from painting the front deck here. It's been really quite a labor to get some of the trim on this house painted. It was never painted and the house is like 10 years old. So trying to fix that wood and put some paint on it has been quite a trip. So anyway, Tristan wanted to smell, and really I tried to be an indulgent dog lover, but boy, I had to just pull him and he was not wanting to come. So let your dog smell. Let him do what he loves to do. There's another place I walk him sometimes with some of his doggy pals, and he's not so interested, but some of the doggy pals love to see the ducks and geese and swans there. And just let your dog sit there and look at the ducks, sit on the bench. They have a lot of benches, and let him admire the ducks or dream of catching one, whatever your dog's dream might be. Because that's such a fun thing for them. And just being in the yard, even with some of your doggy friends, or taking a walk in a place that, like Tristan, used to walk with his friend Chloe on her little walk out to the barn, and he really liked that. So I would put that on his bucket list to have another trip to the barn with the little arrow who's living at that place now. So try to think of things that your dog would really love to do and do them for him. I mean, we love them and they love us. So why not have some fun times with them? And don't wait till they're 100 years old or till you get that bad news that you don't want to hear. Do things with them now that they like to do. So make your dog a bucket list and start checking it off. And you know, it can just be a thing, a list of things that your dog loves. And I highly recommend writing it down, because some of these things, like taking the dog for a ride in the convertible and getting him a little ice cream cone sometime, you can do more than once. I mean, you might have that bucket list and do that thing, those list of things over and over every year, just to give your dog some special time with you, because that is what they want. And you know, I'm so sorry for these dogs that I know that, you know, we have found out won't be with us as long as we thought they were going to be. And you know, having done everything you have wanted and can do and love to do with your dog and that he loves to do before that bad news ever comes your way, certainly will make that transition easier. And one of the other things I suggest while you're doing everything your dog loves and finishing off his bucket list and starting a new one is to think about taking a lot of pictures and making a photo album for him, for you, really. One of the things I did when Comet died, because now everything's digital, I didn't have that many pictures of him as an adult. So I took my phone and I went, and my computer, I think, and I went down to the CVS on a slow day. And there was a person with the photography area there, and she helped me print out, you know, 250 pictures of Comet, which I put into a photo album, and I treasure it. I love looking through it. I love seeing pictures of Comet. I love having something to hold. I love putting some of his fur in those pages with the pictures as well, and some other things from him. So I encourage you to do that now while your dog is still here. Get those pictures in a book if you want, so that you can hold them. Now, some people don't like that. They like to do it digitally, but so you could do a digital photo album, or you can go to something like Snapfish, I think it is, where you can create a book online with pictures of your pet. You don't have to go to the CVS and do what I did, but I encourage you to do that, because it really is meaningful to have those photographs of your pet and to look through them and think how cute he was, and to trace his life from when he was a little puppy to when he's a little boy grown up. So, do some fun things with your dog. The weather is gorgeous on the East Coast this week, although warmer in some places than some people like it. Never warm enough for me here, but 80 is certainly much better than 50, so I'm loving it. And lots more work to do on my painting and yard work, etc. So, everybody enjoy some time with your dog and take some pictures. Have a great week. I don't know when I'll be back. I'm definitely at my educator job Monday and Tuesday, and then my class starts Thursday, which is a 4-day class for craniosacral therapy for animals. And as I've mentioned before, there's a person coming for that class who's pretty interesting. So she's shy. So we might interview her one of those days, but the class starts at 8:30 in the morning every day. So there is no way I will have the time or energy or voice, probably, since I'll be talking 12 hours a day for 4 days to do this. So we might not see you guys for a while. Everybody have a great week. Thanks for joining us, and do some fun things with your pet.